Good morning, neighbors. We're going to sing this song and see if I have the wind for it. We'll get your blood pumping this morning. See if I can sing all the parts. You need backup on this song, I think. On that resurrection morning, when all the dead in Christ shall arise, have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Sown in weakness, raised in power, ready to live in paradise. Have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Well, glory, glory, never sad. There'll be no more sorrow, no more pain, no more strife. Raised up in His likeness, I'll be glad. I'll have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Free from every imperfection, youthful and happy I shall be. Have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Glorified with Him forever, death will be lost in victory. I'll have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Well, glory, glory, never sad. There'll be no more sorrow, no more pain, no more strife. Raised up in His likeness, I'll be glad. I'll have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. What a hallelujah morning when the last trump of God shall sound. Have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Graves all bursting, chains are shouting, heavenly beauty all around. Have a new body, praise the Lord, I'll have a new life. Well, glory, glory, never sad. There'll be no more sorrow, no more pain, and no more strife. Raised up in His likeness, I'll be glad. I'll have a new body, praise the Lord, have a new life.
Like I said, you need backup on that song, and there's no one else here but me. So we do our best. So I thought we'd continue on, just finish out 1 Corinthians chapter 15, because we're talking about the resurrection. And actually, yesterday we read verses that are obviously they got the song from these verses, where it says, "The body is sown in corruption, is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body." And we are waiting for that day. I hear some of the older people say, you know what? The golden years are not so golden, because your body starts, that turns against you, as they say. But there is a promise. You'll have a new body, you'll have a new life, and it will be eternal, and it will be glorified. But I thought we'd read, since we read that yesterday in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 51. It says, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed." I like that. It's not a, I'm thinking we might be changed, or I believe we may be. No, he's saying, "And the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed." We shall be changed. This is going to happen. This is yea and amen. "For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality." That's a beautiful thing. You know, in this world, you know, a lot of people, they want to become famous and things, because then I become immortal. You know, it's just something that lasts forever. But those things, they do not last forever. It's interesting, because I like old movies and things like that, and old radio shows and TV shows, you know, the black and white things. But you mentioned these people who at one time were the most famous people on earth, and now they're almost completely forgotten just by a few people who just happen to take a liking to these things. And if you ask people about great people in history, they're like, oh, no, oh, yeah, I know George Washington, he's the first president. Maybe. You know, some people might, or he's the guy on the quarter, you know, or the dollar bill or something like this, you know, but he really, you know, that beyond that, they're like, I don't know, this man who really changed the world, you know, he's just kind of like, oh, yeah. And he's one of the most famous, and he's still almost forgotten, and, you know, other than the few monuments and things like that, but those things can crumble, they fall apart, and but they try to make this, not the George Washington tried, but we try to make ourselves immortal in this life. Oh, I hear movie stars, oh, and it will live forever. You know, well, no, it just, it's forgotten in time. And there is nothing that's going to last on this earth. Only this will last. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. There's no two ways around it. It must be done. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. So we work and we do these things knowing the things that we're doing, they're not in vain. They are going to have such rewards in heaven, the things that you do in the for the Lord, and how you push away these things of this world and take on the cross and pick it up. We have very little understanding what heaven's going to be like. And it's not going to be some big competition, you know, who gets the greatest of this and that. But know this for sure, the things that you're doing here on earth, it will reap great things in heaven. There's this, it's taken from a verse, Bible, but a man, he kind of changed it for the song. I forget how it goes, but it's basically I think it says, the fields of hope in which I sow, you know, are reaped in heaven, really. It's then you see, oh my goodness, this is the difference I made. This is what I did. You may look at yourself, I haven't done much. But whether you did or didn't, I don't know. All I know is this. We'll see in heaven much more of the harvest of what we had helped to do. And I just pray that we can all do our best. And that's really all we can do. So in Jesus Christ's name, amen.